Put it down.
Of course. Tau Adair, isn't it?
I'm not here to talk.
What a shame.
Adair! Adair, are you receiving?
I'm here, Admiral.
No, you're not here. That is a problem. We were counting on you to stop an Imperial strike team on Ord Trossi. They came in fast and overwhelmed ground security. Half their planetary defense grid is gone.
I'm sorry to hear that, Admiral, but this lead took priority.
Priority? Are you telling me your little antique hunt was more important to the Jedi than protecting Republic citizens?
Stopping Malgus will keep the Republic safe. We needed something to push our investigation forward. And I think I found it.
Well, I hope the price we paid was worth it. Rava, out.
Get me the commander. It's urgent.
That. Perfect timing.
Good, you're here. Didn't want to put this in anyone's hands but yours. Ugh, sorry. Some greasy Sith really didn't want me to have that.
You were in such a rush when you sent me that message. You didn't say what you found.
That belonged to Darth Null. Took us ages to find it, but it was worth it.
I'm sorry I wasn't there to help you.
You are helping. Why do you think I came straight here? Arn and the old man have been breaking their backs looking for patterns in what we know about Darth Null, hoping to find another fortress. They must have read every report on Null at least 20 times apiece. They finally narrowed it down to a few places that seemed like good candidates. We split up and started looking. I was the lucky winner, the one who knows the least about this stuff, but I'm hoping you can help me fix that.
I've got specialists on just about any crazy force thing you can imagine. We all put our heads together, we'll figure out what this is. I'll see what Dr. Ogurab says. My science expert.
A science expert? Not what I was expecting to hear, but I'm open to anything at this point.
Oh, don't let him hear you say that. Not unless you want to volunteer for one of Doc's many new research projects.
Let's see if he can help us, but be ready for questions. He's going to want to know every detail about the place where you found this.
Come on. How bad can he be?
Not now, Sahar.
Just try. I know you have it in you.
That's not what your precious Jedi said.
It's what I'm saying.
I found my way without your sorcery. Had to cut my slave collar with this. She gave me a choice. Die or fight back. I fought, and I excelled, Sahar. The day I became a Mandalorian, I knew I found my home.
I hoped you would find success. You always had fire.
I had little choice. Some earn what they have. Some are given everything.
And some lose it all.
You dare speak to me about suffering?
Even the best armor has flaws. Spaces between plates of Beskar steel where blood can be drawn. The events of Ruhnuk have shown me our flaws. I planned for Shaevisla to find us. She did. I challenged her and was nearly defeated. An outcome that was not expected. How could my plan so miss the mark? I asked myself. I looked and looked and finally found my answer. Someone did not honor their agreements. Someone valued credits over their own life. Basque Sun used one of his pretty machines to make sure I didn't win the duel. He died like a coward. Because of him, we lost Ruhnuk. Because of me, we gained a great deal more. Sahar, can you come up here? This one brought me something taken from the clutches of Darth Malgus. Something so powerful, both the Sith and the Jedi race across the galaxy to claim it. With Sahar's help, we can unlock its secrets.
I told you, Hedda, we shouldn't do this. It's not safe.
You're right. It's never safe to change a galaxy. Never easy to fight corruption and hypocrisy. But your brother said you would face anything to restore balance. Each of you will gather the resources needed to make my vision a reality. You will have your assignments, but none will know the whole plan except myself and Sahar. At long last, we will take back what is ours.
So, I heard you ran into Sahar. Is she all right? Can't believe she's gotten herself mixed up in all that Mandalorian business.
I got the feeling that she's going to follow her brother, as long as he'll let her.
Right. Her brother. You know, I barely even remember her mentioning a brother on Ossus. Now he's got her turning her back on us.
Over here! I do believe I've found something. But first, you must tell me more about this containment device you encountered. What did it look like? How did it work?
I didn't get a chance to look closely at it or anything. I just know it was some kind of trap and that relic was in it.
What do you think this relic is?
It's not what I think. It's what the science tells me. From the results, I can say with certainty that what you found is the remnant of a lightsaber. But there is more to the story.
What else did you find?
A very interesting clue. My equipment also found microscopic fragments of the lightsaber's power source. By all indications, the crystal used to construct the weapon originated in the Adika system.
That's where Ossus is. Jedi get crystals from the Adika system to build their lightsabers. We have for hundreds of years.
So why did Darth Null have a lightsaber that was built like a Jedi's?
A very pertinent question.
Well, she was helping the Emperor control people through the Force, right? I'll bet she used those crystals in some horrible machine that hunted down Jedi and turned them into children of the Emperor.
From everything I've heard about the children of the Emperor, it makes sense.
And who knows what else she designed that has yet to be uncovered? In theory, the possibilities are limitless from all she seemed to know. Someone who does not shy away from knowledge, no matter its source, in order to create, to expand their awareness. It is admirable.
Null was controlling people's minds. Let's not pin any medals on her just yet. What do you think about talking to Malgus again? You've got something up your sleeve you didn't have last time.
We're getting nowhere with him. I'd rather focus on our own investigations into Darth Null without getting sidetracked by Malgus.
It's frustrating, I get it. But we might know something Malgus doesn't. When else will we get a chance to catch him off guard?
All right. While we wait for more intel to come in, I'll see Malgus.
I do not envy you having to attempt any sort of communication with that ill-tempered brute.
Thank you both for your help on this.
It has been my pleasure.
No problem. I'm going to let the old man know what we found. He and Arn will be dying to hear everything.
The chat you had with Dr. Ogurov paints a better picture of what Malgus may have been up to. Darth Null's work on mind control says a lot, but combining Sith and Jedi toys? That's big news. Malgus following in the footsteps of someone with Jedi connections is a plot twist I wasn't expecting. Never mind Hedda Kohl getting her hands on Darth Null's holocron.
Do we know what's on there?
We don't, but we need to assume that whoever holds that holocron holds the advantage. Malgus has the information we need, but he isn't talking. We're not running blind, however. What we learned about Darth Null's Jedi influence does give us something to go on, though admittedly not much.
Hands up. Looks like we have a special guest.
Tell these droids to get out of my way. I need to speak to Malgus.
They answer only to the Supreme Chancellor and cannot be overridden, Shay.
Some higher-up is all sweaty about my past contracts with Malgus. They've got no understanding of how those things work.
One of those contracts was destroying the defense grid on Coruscant during an Imperial invasion.
I was there to do a job. I did it and moved on. You should understand that. You and I have an understanding, but I owe no loyalty to the Republic or to the Empire, Malgus included.
Perhaps, but permission to interrogate the prisoner is restricted to a select few.
I'm going to find out if he's working with Hedda, with or without permission.
This is not the place to start a fight.
I don't start fights. I end them. I need you to trust me. Like back on Ruhnuk. So, what's it gonna be?
We'll work together on this.
Smart move.
Doesn't change the fact that Shay isn't on the VIP list.
Then put me on comms.
Comms? To listen in?
More than that. Shay can give advice during my questioning.
Malgus had a few bad habits when I worked with him. I'm betting they're still there. If you listen to me, we can trip him up.
Risky. But the situation calls for it.
At least we'll be in full control. If anything seems wrong, we can shut it down.
Stay alert no matter what. I'm going in. You ready?
Always.
Threats are useless against Malgus. He fears nothing. You keep talking about putting an end to what he wants, and we'll get nowhere. Make him think you understand. That's the key to getting anything out of him.
Still sitting on the throne of defeat.
I told you he won't respond to that. Get him to think you're on his side.
We did a little digging. Darth Null actually used some Jedi techniques. That must be a shock to you.
Do you think there is any knowledge of Darth Null that I do not already possess? It was only a matter of time before you discovered the connection. Her mastery of Jedi secrets is woven into all of her creation. Like her, my vision surmounts Jedi and Sith, Empire and Republic.
Showing our hand wouldn't have been my choice, but it got him talking. Ask about Hedda.
But where does this all end? What happens if you succeed?
I will tear apart the corrupt systems that allow weakness to infect the galaxy. I will stop the rot. I will burn down all of their failing legacies and see who embraces the flame.
More of his mystical Ossus. What about the holocron? Does Hedda have something she can use against my people?
Who whispers in your ear? Shay Fizzler.
Cut it out. This is between you and me.
It is too late.
Your thoughts are plain to me, Mandalore the Avenger. Your rage consumes you.
There was a battle, and your prey slipped through your fingers.
Your people are divided, while Hetta Kol gathers her army.
You are right to come begging for answers. Hetta will destroy you.
Where is she? Dinila Hutun! Answer me!
Looms over us all. A shadow of unchanging history. There are fools who believe they can outrun the shadow. Without a flame to chase it away, it will consume them. they are doomed to repeat the same failures. None who have stood by my side have understood this. The only one who could have is my enemy. A shame that you and I must remain that way.
All your plans have caused so much damage. I don't know how we could ever be anything else.
Greetings. I'm relieved you answered. I must make an unusual request.
What's going on? Is everything all right?
Yes. For the moment, I have been summoned by the Three. What they had to say has left me disquieted. Meet me at these coordinates on Voss, and I will explain in greater detail.
I sent you to look into the origins of one of Darth Null's relics. I haven't heard any updates.
What I found. It is best if I show you in person. I will await your arrival.
Voss. Well, at least it's nice this time of year.
We have enough mysteries to contend with without getting the Voss involved. They're not exactly known for being straightforward. Sana-Rae sounded unlike herself. I do hope whatever she has to tell you isn't too troubling.
You're here. Sana-Rae hoped you would come quickly.
You're a sight for sore eyes. Glad to have you back.
Thank you. I am glad to have returned. With something useful, I hope.
Sana-Rae didn't tell me you'd be here. You caught me off guard.
I am sure it slipped her mind. She has been speaking to some other Voss about something, and she has seemed unsettled.
You have arrived. Good. I have been waiting to show you this. When we first uncovered the existence of Darth Null, I could not imagine that tracing the origins of one of her relics would lead here. The strange ruins Arcann found on the planet in wild space. They were resistant to his presence for a reason.
But together we found something.
What you are about to see. Darth Null possessed a talent that was unique among her kind. Through the Force, she could connect her mind to another's. Darth Null could speak to someone's most hidden desires, reach depths of their thoughts they could not reach themselves. Over great distances, she could mentally bond with anyone who could feel the Force. In those who did not recognize their own abilities, she awakened that realization.
Sharing this knowledge was unacceptable to those around Darth Null. She was ostracized, friendless.
Darth Null took those who would follow her to an empty world in wild space, where they could do as they pleased, without judgment. Null taught her disciples how to forge mental bonds as she did. They called out to others and invited them to their sanctuary.
But Darth Null was careless. She made contact with someone she shouldn't have. The Sith Emperor, as he was then. He took advantage of her mistake. He ruthlessly pursued her.
Before the Emperor could reach her followers, Null locked many of their secrets away in the ruins Arcann found. Null and the others fought back against their captors, but their fate was sealed. The Emperor dominated the minds of her disciples, bent them to his will, enslaved them. After that day, Null's followers became servants of the Emperor, and she became Darth Null.
If the Emperor made her Darth Null after she was captured, who was she before?
She was no one. At least, not after she was expelled from the Jedi Order.
You're telling me that Darth Null, the woman that Malgus blindly reveres, she was a Jedi?
For a time. The account of Darth Null's removal from the Jedi is told from her own perspective. We do not know much about what transpired before that, other than what she was called, Master Renaya.
Every time we learn something about Darth Null, it adds more pieces to the puzzle. And we still don't know what she did that inspired Malgus's plans.
But now the truth has come to light. If Malgus wanted to hide it forever, he failed.
All that you found about Darth Null, why did I have to come to Voss to hear it?
After I heeded the Three's request to return to Voss, I heard whisperings. Rumors of a vision that caused great concern among the mystics. The Three forbade them to speak about what was seen. A revelation centered on Darth Malgus.
You brought me here to find out more about the vision.
I brought you here to try. The Three know well the value you would place on hearing the details of this vision. But they would never share them with an outsider, even one of your status, unless you gave them a reason to.
Can't you ask them about the vision?
They would not reveal it to me. But there is another way. Despite our best efforts, some of our most sacred temples have yet to be rebuilt in the years since Vaylin's assault. The Shrine of Contemplation is too deep within Gormak lands. The work is slow, even with aid from the few Gormak who have chosen to continue their alliance with the Voss. The Three are overseeing progress at the Shrine of Contemplation now. If you were to approach them and offer your assistance, perhaps you will change their minds about the vision. With luck, they will be receptive to one with your gracious reputation.
I've already made an impression on them. This shouldn't be difficult.
It has been years since you first came to Voss. The members of the Three have changed many times since then, but they all expect the same courtesies. Be conscious of the struggles of Voss. Be considerate of our views. Little else is needed.
I'd like to speak with you for a moment before you depart.
Here are the coordinates for the Shrine of Contemplation. I will send a message ahead to the commandos there to expect your arrival.
You wanted to speak to me about something?
All this talk of visions, it reminded me. Something strange happened while I was away. As I searched Darth Maul's ruins, every step I took felt so familiar, like I had been there before.
The Emperor did take Darth Null from there. Did your father... Did Valkorion go back to relive old history?
If he had, he would have never allowed me to accompany him. Something I'm grateful for now. It was confusing, distressingly so. I was so certain I had stood on the surface of that empty world, even though I could not remember when or why. I spoke with Sana-Rae about this sense of familiarity. It didn't take long before she understood what I was feeling. I was there, in those ruins, once before, during the ritual in the Shrine of Healing.
How is that possible?
I am unsure. This realization awakened other memories of what I saw while the Voss healed me. I believed they were dreams at the time, but Sana-Rae believes otherwise. She says they were visions.
Visions of the future? Like the Voss mystics who performed your healing ritual?
Yes, the very same. In the ritual, the mystics infused part of their spirit with yours. It is not uncommon for a mystic's gifts to be shared with the one they are cleansing. They opened my mind to unreachable distances. The past. What may happen. What never will. In truth, it is all still a blur. It was as if I lived decades in the span of hours. I saw centuries worth of horrors committed by my father. I felt the rage and the cruelty born of my desperation to please him. The suffering and the devastation I caused, it was all made plain to me. When I learned what my father had done in Darth Maul's ruins, old fears resurfaced. I was afraid I saw those ruins because I was doomed to follow in his footsteps. But there were visions of hope as well, of serving a greater purpose. I saw the work I could do, how I could dedicate myself to atonement, like helping you stop Darth Malgus. Reliving that vision, it reminded me that I have far to go before I can be forgiven for all that I inflicted upon others, if that is even possible. But I am moving in the right direction.
You can't always fix what's broken. Sometimes there's just too much pain to let go.
I know. I will never expect forgiveness, or even acceptance from anyone I have hurt. But I will cherish any that is offered. I don't think I could have ever seen things in this light without your help. There will never be enough I can do to thank you.